This isn't your grandparents' weed. Why is 21st century cannabis so much stronger than the stuff from the Cheech and Chong era? It's high time we find out. The most widely used federally prohibited drug in the United States is cannabis, though it is legal for recreational or medical use in all but 4 states in the nation. In 2020, 49.6 million people reported using some form of cannabis, according to the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration. However, aside from its rising popularity, the drug has been associated with an increase in potency in the past few years. Potency is linked to levels of tetrahydrocannabinol, or THC, which is responsible for cannabis's psychoactive effects. There are several reasons for this: an improvement in cultivation techniques, a better understanding of how the plant works, and being able to grow it in controlled environments rather than having to illegally import it. Speaking to NPR, Stacey Gruber, director of the Marijuana Investigations for Neuroscientific Discovery Program, pointed to studies suggesting an over 300% increase in THC content from 1995 to 2017. Elsewhere, a 2018 paper published at the National Library of Medicine about the potency of cannabis in Colorado revealed that between 1995 and 2015, there was a huge 212% jump in THC content found in cannabis flower. Additionally, some products that contain THC, such as edibles and oil, can contain upwards of 95% THC despite there being no research to support this amount being beneficial for medical purposes. Basically, most cannabis bought nowadays will give you much more of a high than the stuff bought in the 1970s or even the 1990s would.
Look at all these twigs. Because from the earth. Man, 80s weed sucks.
The history of cannabis and how it became stronger over time goes way back. Data from the Natural Center for Natural Products Research found that cannabis available today is on average 57% to 67% stronger than samples taken from the 1970s. This could partly be because cannabis no longer needs to be imported as much. In the 1970s, cannabis was illegally smuggled in from countries like Colombia. Along the journey, the flowers would dry out due to being compressed into bricks, which made it easier to transport large amounts. Factors like light and heat reduced the potency of the plant within these bricks, meaning that what most people ended up smoking contained less THC to actually give you a high. Cannabis cultivation techniques are more advanced than ever, and we know a lot more about how to get the best out of the flower. From the 80s onwards, hydroponic growing systems expanded in popularity, and growers started choosing strains with the highest potency, think the namesake strain from Pineapple Express, while staying continually focused on growing the most potent species of the cannabis plant, Sinsamilla. Sinsamilla, which simply means the flower does not produce seeds, is the most commonly dispensary-grown plant and has the highest levels of THC. In contrast, people in the past bought unregulated bags of cannabis that had been grown outdoors and shipped long distances and included the compressed stems, seeds, and leaves along with the flower. As cannabis gets stronger, so does the risk of addiction because of the higher levels of THC. Dr. Tom Freeman, director of the Addiction and Mental Health Group at the University of Bath, shared, "As the strength of cannabis has increased, so too has the number of people entering treatment for cannabis use problems. More Europeans are now entering drug treatment because of cannabis than heroin or cocaine. Though cannabis does not carry the same risk as those drugs, the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration says it can still have some undesired side effects. Because of this, it's always important to check the source of your cannabis so you can get information like the level of THC before you smoke or ingest the product. If you or anyone you know needs help with addiction issues, help is available. Visit the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration website or contact SAMHSA's National Helpline at 1-800-662-HELP-4357.